In the mid-1930s, the RAF struggles to improve its aging fleet of planes, while its clearest rival, Germany, develops and builds the fastest and deadliest planes in the world. To close the gap, the RAF forms a competition for a plane that can intercept the speedy German bombers.
R.J. Mitchell was the chief designer of the Supermarine Aviation Company. He was a very direct man, a very talented man. He designed superb aeroplanes that were really quite fast and maneuverable. So he was used to working with new technology, but more than that, he saw the storm clouds of war rising within Germany, and he knew Europe would be at war. He was a very sick man. He was dying of cancer, and he knew that, but he felt he was keen to ensure that the Royal Air Force had the best airplane that they could have before he passed away. His first few attempts to design an airplane to meet that specification were not particularly successful, but he kept going.
Mitchell and his design team hit on a radical idea, giving the plane a thin, elliptical-shaped wing.
The problem the design team had was to combine power with speed and agility and have a formidable weaponry to down the enemy fighters and bombers. The solution the design team came up with was this thin, elliptical wing that met the performance requirements but could allow a retractable landing gear and an array of weaponry, 4 machine guns per wing, that could be adapted to accommodate cannon.
Mitchell and his design team create the airframe, and Rolls-Royce builds its heart, a new superpowered engine called the Merlin.
Marrying Mitchell's designs with the Rolls-Royce Merlin is going to create one of the greatest aircraft in the history of warfare.
Racing at speeds over 350 miles per hour, climbing 2,500 feet per minute, and able to outturn most German planes. The Spitfire is a pilot's dream.
So the Spitfire, first and foremost, is a graceful looking aeroplane. That doesn't hide the fact, though, that it's a sleek killing machine. It fits you well. You sit in the aeroplane, you feel like you wear the aeroplane, you feel like you're part of it. She smells good, you know, she's quite hot. That big Rolls-Royce Merlin engine that's only a few feet in front of your feet. Just have to think, I want to go in that direction. And you just gently move the stick and she responds beautifully for you. She gives you confidence. And that's one of the key things as somebody going into war in an aeroplane. You've got to be at one with your machine. You've got to be confident in that machine, your ability to operate it.
The Spitfire's unique silhouette and the Rolls-Royce Merlin engine's distinctive growl become the symbol of British resistance.